So now I should I start mine? Should we start?
Yeah, we can start here.
Okay. Now I invite Dr. Vikas Dugal to formally introduce our resource person for today's session. Then we will start.
Good evening to all. On the behalf of the Department of Physics, DAV College, Bathinda, I welcome you all on the fifth day of the 1 week online interdepartmental workshop on MS Excel spreadsheet as tool for enhancing mathematical and computational skills. The topic of the today's talk is hitting the bull's eye. Let us calculate pi, a Monte Carlo approach. I would like to introduce today's presenter, Professor Sarmishta Sahuji. He is a retired professor of physics, Maharani Lakshmi Mani College, Bangalore, and coordinator of Indian Association of Physics Teachers, Bangalore. He has completed three UGC minor research projects. He has published many research papers in national and international journals. He is 6 times the winner of a prestigious award, National Competition of Innovative Experiments, and 3 times bagged National Competition of Innovative Computational Physics. I am sure that participants will gain a lot from her lecture. Again, I would welcome Professor Sarmishta Sahuji, Professor P. K. Aluwalia, and Dr. Sapna Sharma ji to join this workshop. I am extremely thankful on the behalf of DAV College Bathinda and DAV College Management Committee in New Delhi. Without
Good
wasting
evening.
my time, now I request Professor Sahu to deliver her.
Ma'am, please to join your mic.
Thank you very much for your nice words. It's really related to me. I'm so happy. It is, in fact, a very apt topic for a mixed group. We call this as interdepartmental, and the topic today's topic is very much interdependent on different things, subjects. You can appreciate as a mathematician, as a physicist, as a chemist, as a chemical engineer, as a financial processing, what personal, anybody. So it is definitely going to help all of us if we pay attention and then work together. So my only request is I want this to become an interactive session. All of us have been muted, but I would request every one of you to take chance one after another and to please participate in the entire process. This is going to be a wonderful game for all of us to play together. Are you ready? Students, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
I want all of you, if you have a computer and an Excel in the computer, please open it and keep it ready. We are going to play together. Is that all right with you? Can you open
Yes,
your computers? Yes, okay. So even if you don't have a computer, you can pay attention and do it mentally. But if you have a computer, it would be wonderful if you do it yourself along with me. All right, okay. So I said first we will have nothing to do with Excel. We are going to play a game. And everyone, including adults and children, love to play. I also enjoy playing. Even though I am a senior citizen, I love to play. And every time we have a party game. So this is a party of physics that we are having today. So, and we are now going to play the party game. So all of us have played with the Housy. How many of you have not heard of Housy? Please tell me. Yes, you have not heard of Housy. Housy is a game where one of the organizers calls out name and he gives us a slip of paper. There are some numbers written on that paper, exactly 15 numbers written on that paper from 0 to 90. And if your numbers are called out, depending upon the announcement, if it is called out, then you get the prize. If you are the first person to tick all the numbers that has been called out, that is what is known as Housy. And what is so special about Housy? Why do children love playing Housy? It is because when they are calling out the numbers, including the organizers, nobody knows which number will be called out next. Can anybody tell me for sure that the next number will be 3 if the numbers are being called at a random. Can you guess what is the number that is going to come?
No.
Yes or no? Now, do you recollect Housie? How many of you have heard of Housie?
We used to play it with another name called Bingo.
Bingo. Okay. So, do you know about Bingo? Can you just explain in one word what is Bingo? Let me also be aware of it. Yes. Please tell me.
We wrote 25 numbers.
Okay.
Each of us called one number at a chance. Everyone will cut that number. Whoever first strikes 5 lines with the cutting of the numbers wins.
Okay. So something similar. And now sir has told me it is not called Housie, it is called Tambola. Yes, Tambola is also another name. Now I think you know what I'm talking about. Tambola. Okay. So we are going to play a game like that, something similar to Tambola. So what do I do first? I have over here, can you see this? I have a bag and inside the bag, I have plenty of numbers. Look at the numbers over here. These are the numbers that is there. All the numbers starting from 0 to 90 are over here. All right. This bag is full of numbers or number coins. I am going to take out one coin at a time. And how many of you are there? 20 people are there. Okay, so I will say all the persons who have name A to M will call the first number that I call out as X. So suppose I'm calling out this number, which is 69. Okay, 69. Then for A to M, all these children, they will call this number as X. And rest of them, N to Z, those who have names starting from N to Z, will call it as Y. Okay, I want actually two groups. That is how I am dividing the group into the entire into two teams. All right. Then when I call out the next number, I am calling it out as 89. When I say 89, those of you who have taken the first number as X will call this as Y. Those of you who have called the first number as Y will take it as X. Did you understand? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. Do you have a sheet of paper which I had requested you to bring it along with you? There is a tabular column. Heading is X and Y. So first when I'm calling out, some of you are calling the first number as X. Others are calling it as Y. So write it in the tabular column. Next number when I'm calling out, those of you who have written it as X will write Y. And those of you who have written the first number as Y will call it as X. Is that clear? Aapko samajh mein aaya main kya bol rahi hoon? Aapne mein ek baar kya bol rahi hoon? Nahi, paper, aapke paas paper hai, pen hai? Paper hai? Pen hai?
Yes, ma'am.
Wo paper mein X aur Y column hai?
Yes, ma'am.
ठीक है. जिन जिन का नाम A से M तक शुरू होता है, मंजीत और अरविंद, all of you are in the first team. और जिनका नाम N से Z तक शुरू होता है, वो लोग second team में हैं. जो लोग first team में हैं, मैं जो number बुलाऊंगी, unfortunately you don't have a bag. So since you don't have a bag, I am going to call out the numbers, and all of you will follow whatever number I am calling out. So all of us are playing together with just one bag. All right. So those of you who will call the first number as X, rest of them will call it as Y and write it in the paper. All right. Then I will call out another number. I'll put this back into this bag. Then I will shake it thoroughly and I will take out the next number. When I take out the next number, I will call it out loudly. So you will write it in the appropriate box, either X or Y, as I explained to you. And then we will have one coordinate X coordinate, one Y coordinate. And if I'm calling this as X coordinate and Y coordinate, I can mark one point in my graph paper. Do you have a graph paper in which there is a quarter of a circle marked? Yes or no?
Yes.
Hai, aapke paas hai? Kitne logon ke paas hai? यस मैम, बहुत कम लोग हाँ बोल रहे हैं. अगर आपके पास नहीं है तो एक पेपर लीजिए और दो लाइन एक्स एंड वाई एक्सिस बना दीजिए परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर. एक्स एक्सिस में 1 सेंटीमीटर में आप लिख लीजिए 10, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40 up to 90. Y एक्सिस में भी लिख लीजिए 0, 10, 20, 30, 40 up to 90. प्लीज डू इट. इफ यू डू इट यू विल अंडरस्टैंड इट बेटर. You will actually need no explanation. It will become self-explanatory. So I want you to play with me. At एक पेपर लीजिए, x y coordinate बनाइए, axis में 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 90 तक लिख लीजिए, y axis में भी 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 90 तक लिख लीजिए. एक मिनट में टाइम छोड़ रही हूँ. प्लीज कंप्लीट इट.
Please show the paper on the screen, please, ma'am.
Yeah, if you can show it to me, like I have done it, I will show it to you. This is how I have done. I have written over here 0 to 90. I have written over here 0 to 90. If you have a graph sheet, it is better. But if you don't have a graph sheet, ordinary paper mein aap bana lijiye, please. Unfortunately, we can't reach each other. If it was a classroom, I could have handed over the graph sheet and you could have done it. But then right now we don't have a situation where all of us are together. All of us are sitting independently in our homes and therefore I can't reach you with these graph sheets, etc. So you please collect yours. If you don't have a graph sheet, make it in a plain sheet of paper. Karenge, please?
Haan, yes. Please.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Dusre bhi, sabko hi bataiye, please. Banaoge? बन गया.
यस मैम.
यस, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. अब चैट में लिख लेते हैं. वेरी गुड, थैंक यू सो मच, थैंक यू रियली सो मच. आप कर चुके हैं, हो गया क्या?
यस मैम. यस मैम.
तो वी आर रेडी. और एक पेपर में एक्स वाई कॉलम है और इन इनसाइड आउटसाइड आई हैव रिटन. थर्ड कॉलम में अगर वो तीन कॉलम है तो शुरू करेंगे. रेडी?
Yes, ma'am.
तो मैं हिला रही हूँ और एक कॉइन निकाल रही हूँ. द फर्स्ट नंबर इज 81. आप लिखिए 81 आइदर एक्स कॉलम में नहीं तो वाई कॉलम में, जो आपको ठीक लगता है वैसे लिखिए 81. हो गया. नेक्स्ट आई एम पुटिंग इट. और एक निकाला, ये मेरा नेक्स्ट नंबर इज 31. So, अगर आप x लिखे हैं तो y लिखेंगे, अगर आप y लिखे हैं तो x लिखेंगे. ठीक है. सो द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज डन. फिर मैं उसको डाली और एक बार निकाल रही हूं. नेक्स्ट नंबर इज 17. जो x करना चाहिए वो x कीजिए, जिन लोगों को y करना चाहिए वो y कीजिए. फिर बैग में डाल दी और एक निकाला, ये है 16. हो गया. आपको कुछ मिलने वाला है इसीलिए अच्छे से खेलिए, अच्छे से खेलिए. फिर मैं नेक्स्ट निकाल रही हूं, नंबर 80. हुआ. आई वॉन्ट ऑल द टीचर्स ऑल्सो टू प्ले, इट इज रियल फन, सो प्लीज डू इट. 80. नेक्स्ट नंबर 73. मैं भी लिख रही हूं, मैं भी लिख रही हूं. नेक्स्ट नंबर 82 56. मैं एवरी टाइम आई एम टेकिंग आउट अ कॉइन एंड कॉलिंग आउट द नंबर एंड पुटिंग बैक द कॉइन इन टू द बॉक्स सो दैट ऑल द कॉइन्स आर देयर फॉर द नेक्स्ट राउंड. नो कॉइन इज मिसिंग. 63. नेक्स्ट नंबर 53. तो मेरे पास अभी 5 पॉइंट हो गए. 10 नंबर है और 5 पॉइंट है. पॉइंट क्या? एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट, वाई कोऑर्डिनेट, एक पॉइंट. Next x coordinate, y coordinate, one point, and so on. I'll do it again, another 5 more points, and we'll stop. 11. Seven. 57. 80. 74.
मैम नंबर्स रिपीट हो सकते हैं?
हाँ हो सकते हैं, क्योंकि मैं वही कॉइन फिर वापस बैग में डाल रही हूँ, तो बैग में हरदम जब मैं निकाल रही हूँ 90 नंबर्स हैं, 0 to 90 ऑल द नंबर्स आर देयर, देयरफॉर द सेम कॉइन कैन कम टू माय हैंड, इट इज श्योर लक। मैं कुछ नहीं कर रही हूँ, मैं तो आराम से उसको मिक्स कर रही हूँ और एक एक करके कॉइन निकाल रही हूँ। अगर आ गया तो मैं कुछ नहीं कर सकती, इट इज पॉसिबल। ओके, सो 37, 42, 4 and 2, 42. 1, 3, 13. 5, 9, 59. 6, 9, 69. 2, 1, 21. 7, 1, 71, और ज्यादा कर रही हूं, 6, 4, 64. Only number 6, 7, 9, 79. 1, 6, 16. 7, 4, 74. I'll do a few more and then we'll stop. 7, 1, 71. 1, 5, 9, 59, 4, 9, 49, 3, 3, 33, 7, 5, 75, 7, 6, 76, 6, 1, 61, 4, 4, 44, 5, 5, 55, and the last point, 1, 7, 17, 1, 5, 15. Let's stop over here. So now we have pairs of points, pairs of numbers, I would request you consider this x as x coordinate and y coordinate and mark a point on that sheet where you have marked 0 to 90. I forgot to tell you. And I also want you to make a quarter of a circle starting from 90 on the y axis to 90 on the x axis. Make a freehand drawing and make it quarter of a circle. Do you understand what is quarter of a circle? आप पूरा सर्कल नहीं करके एक सर्कल का एक चौथा बनाना है. कहां से शुरू करेंगे? 90 से शुरू कीजिए y एक्सिस, x एक्सिस 90 तक लेके आइए एक आर्क विच फॉर्म्स क्वार्टर ऑफ द सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ अ सर्कल. नाउ दिस इज व्हाट आई वांट यू टू डू. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड. फ्रॉम 90 आई स्टार्टेड, मेड अ कर्व एंड केम टू दिस 90. दिस शुड लुक लाइक अ quarter of a circle. Now this is becoming a quarter of a circle. So the center of the circle is over here. It has a radius equivalent to 90 and the circumference is like this. You please plot this first. Even if it is plain paper, doesn't matter. Aap freehand draw kar payenge to please kijiye. Aapke paas immediately rounder nahi hoga. Isiliye agar aap karke laaye hain to use kijiye. अगर आपके पास नहीं है तो ऑर्डिनरी पेपर में एक आर्क बना के रखिए. ओके, होप यू हैव डन इट. किया?
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
और कोई किया है? रजनी, जीवन कुमार, कौर, अंबिका?
यस मैम.
यस यस मैम.
तो अभी क्या करना है, आपको अंदाज से पॉइंट लगाना है. आपके पास अगर ग्राफ पेपर है तो बहुत इजी है. 10-20 लिखा है तो 10, 0 टू 10 में 10 लाइन है तो इट विल बिकम 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. तो आपको पॉइंट लगाने में इजी होगा. फर्स्ट कोऑर्डिनेट हमारा था कुछ, सेकंड कोऑर्डिनेट कुछ था, एक था एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट, एक तो वाई कोऑर्डिनेट. आप अपना नंबर देख के पॉइंट लगा दीजिए. कितने पॉइंट होने चाहिए? ट्वेंटी पॉइंट्स होने चाहिए. ओके, प्लीज आप कर पाएंगे? एक मिनट में छोड़ती हूं टाइम, प्लीज कर दीजिए. आपके जो नंबर्स हैं, फर्स्ट टू नंबर्स एक पॉइंट, सेकंड टू नंबर्स एक पॉइंट, ऐसे करके 20 पॉइंट्स आप अपना ड्रॉ पॉइंट कर दीजिए पेंसिल में, नहीं तो पेन में. आप पॉइंट जब डाल रहे हैं तो क्या कर रहे हैं? मैं आपको बोली कि एक क्वार्टर ऑफ अ सर्कल ड्रॉ कीजिए. अगर आप वो 90 के पास एक टेंजेंट करेंगे और एक्स एक्सिस 90 के पास एक टेंजेंट करेंगे, वो एक पॉइंट में मीट करेगा और आपको लगेगा कि देर इज अ स्क्वायर एंड इनसाइड द स्क्वायर देर इज अ क्वार्टर ऑफ एन सर्कल इंस्क्राइब्ड. इंस्क्राइब्ड आपको मालूम होगा जरूर, हम बच्चे क्लास 6-7 में पढ़ चुके हैं. इंस्क्राइब्ड क्या होता है? आपका शीट में एक क्वार्टर ऑफ अ सर्कल बनाए हैं, वहां पे अगर आप टेंजेंशियली एक ड्रॉ करेंगे लाइन तो एक स्क्वायर बन जाएगा. मैं यहाँ पे दिखा रही हूं, यहाँ पे 90 में एक स्ट्रेट लाइन बनाया टेंजेंशियल, इस 90 में एक टेंजेंशियल लाइन बनाया, ये दोनों टेंजेंट मीट कर चुके हैं यहां पे. सो दिस इज अ स्क्वायर एंड इनसाइड द स्क्वायर आई हैव अ क्वार्टर ऑफ अ सर्कल इंस्क्राइब्ड. बिकॉज इट इज अ टेंजेंट, ऑब्वियसली इट इज टचिंग द स्क्वायर एंड देयरफॉर इट इज इंस्क्राइब्ड. यस और नो?
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
अभी पॉइंट लगाते जाइए प्लीज. प्लेन पेपर में अंदाज से लगाइए, ग्राफ पेपर है तो बराबर भी लगा पाएंगे. कैसे भी आपके सुविधा के अनुसार प्लीज कीजिए. मैं भी कर पाऊंगी पर आई एम नॉट स्पेंडिंग टाइम. आप कीजिए, मैं आपसे इंफॉर्मेशन ले लूंगी. मैं भी कर रही हूँ. मैं जानबूझ के कर रही हूं कि सो दैट आई विल नो हाउ मच टाइम इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर प्लॉटिंग. मेरा खत्म हो गया. अभी आपको और एक चीज करनी है. आपके पास एक क्वार्टर ऑफ अ सर्कल है और एक स्क्वायर है. जितने पॉइंट्स आप बनाए हैं वो स्क्वायर में है कि नहीं? All the points that you have made just now, is it inside the square? Yes or no? Yes. So totally there are 20 points in the square. उसको हम NS लिख लेते हैं. So NS is equivalent to 20. Yes or no?
Yes ma'am.
अच्छा, वो जो 20 points आप बनाए, all the points are they inside the circle?
No ma'am.
No. So there are some points which are inside the circle. Some of them are outside the circle. Count all the points which are there inside the circle. Count. It will be different. I will not be able to tell. But you tell me how many points you have inside.
15 inside the circle, ma'am.
Okay. So somebody is telling it is 15. दूसरे क्या बोल रहे हैं?
मैम मार्क कर रही थी अभी, थोड़े से रहते थे.
अच्छा, तो थोड़ा रुकेंगे, आप मार्क कीजिए. और अप्रोक्सीमेटली कर रहे हैं तो इतना बहुत एक्यूरेट होने की जरूरत नहीं है. आप अंदाज करके पॉइंट करते जाइए. असल में ईच पॉइंट व्हेन यू आर मेकिंग यू कैन मार्क इट. इफ इट इज इनसाइड टिक कर दीजिए, अगर वो बाहर है तो क्रॉस कीजिए. तो जितने भी टिक्स होंगे वो इनसाइड द सर्कल होंगे, जितने क्रॉस होंगे वो आउटसाइड द सर्कल होंगे. थर्ड कॉलम में एक बोली थी आपको बनाने के लिए, उसी में भी मार्क कर सकते हैं. अगर मार्क नहीं किया तो भी चलेगा. होने के बाद जितने भी पॉइंट सर्कल के अंदर हैं वो काउंट कर दीजिए और लिख लीजिए कितने पॉइंट्स हैं. तो समबडी टोल्ड मी ऑलरेडी 15. इनफैक्ट आई हैव ऑल्सो 15. आई हैव 15 पॉइंट्स इनसाइड द सर्कल. Totally there are 20 points and all the 20 points are inside the square. There are no points outside the square. Ho gaya? थोड़ा जल्दी कर दीजिए, नहीं तो वी विल नॉट बी एबल टू गो टू आवर एक्सेल शीट एनी आफ्टर दैट. अप्रोक्सीमेट कीजिए, नो प्रॉब्लम. Second. Okay. Somebody is telling 16 points. Okay. Anybody else? 15 points. 14 points. Very good. Very good. So the, it is totally points have been done. 15 points. 13 points. Very good. Excellent. Now, Abhi, Sunil, you keep that point with you. Number of points. जो नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स इन द स्क्वायर है वो सबका 20 है, जो नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स इन द सर्कल है वो अलग अलग लोगों का अलग अलग है, जो भी है आपका वो लिख लीजिए। सिंबॉलिकली हम रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे एन सी फॉर नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स इन द सर्कल, एन एस फॉर नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स इन द स्क्वायर। ओके, ना आप सुनिए क्या मैं बोल रही हूँ। अगर मैं ऐसे पॉइंट आपको बुलाती जाती, केप्ट ऑन कॉलिंग आउट नंबर्स, देन यू वुड हैव सो मेनी पॉइंट्स इन योर paper. Will this points, when it becomes more and more, sort of cover the area of this circle and the square? Haan ki nahi? It is something like a child painting. Jab wo aap ek bache ko dete ho, paint, crayon, pencil, aur ek circle draw karke dete ho, to wo kya karta hai? Pencil se dheere dheere line kar karke, crayon ko, usko pura circle ko round karta hai. अगर मैं क्रेयॉन नहीं दी पर आपको बोला पॉइंट करो, ऐसे पॉइंट करते जाओगे तो वो कलर माने पॉइंट से भर जाएगा और इट विल कवर द एंटायर सर्कल और द स्क्वायर और बोथ ऑफ देम। तो पॉइंट्स में हम पूरा सर्कल को कवर कर पाएंगे, यस और नो कर पाएंगे? जरूर कर पाएंगे। अगर हम करते जाएंगे ऐसे डॉट 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 तो पूरा भर भी देंगे डॉट में। और ये डॉट जो लगा रहे हैं वो कोई पैटर्न है क्या? आपको फर्स्ट डॉट बाई में डालना पड़ेगा, उसके बाद एक डॉट पढ़ना पड़ेगा, तीसरा डॉट था उसके पास लगाना पड़ेगा, ऐसे कुछ फॉर्मूला है क्या आपके पास?
नो मैम,
नो, इट इज ऑल बीइंग डन रैंडमली। तो आप जो पॉइंट लगा रहे हैं वो रैंडम पॉइंट है। कैसे हम क्रिएट किए वो रैंडम पॉइंट, कौन बोल सकता है? वो रैंडम पॉइंट कैसे जनरेट किए हम, क्या किए?
बैग में से रैंडम नंबर निकाल के।
यस, एक्सेलेंट पृथ्वीराज, एक्सेलेंट। हम बैग में से रैंडम नंबर निकाले तो वी वे जनरेटिंग रैंडम नंबर्स, कॉलिंग देम एज द एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट एंड द वाई कोऑर्डिनेट, and from a pair of these points which were random we tried to generate a point in our graph sheet or plain paper and called it as a random point. Therefore we have been able to create random points in our picture and we were filling up the picture by number of points. Unfortunately due to shortage of time I just called only 20 points. aise agar aapko pura din diya jata to wo aap point mein bhar bhar ke डॉट मार मार के उसको पूरा भर्ती कर दिए, यू वुड हैव फिल्ड इट अप कंप्लीटली। सो देयरफॉर इज द नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स दैट हैज बीन डन नाउ डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द एरिया ऑफ द सर्कल, द नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स विच आर देयर इन द सर्कल, इज इट डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द नंबर ऑफ टू द एरिया ऑफ द सर्कल, अ क्वार्टर ऑफ अ सर्कल, यस और नो? हाँ या नहीं?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Is all the points that I'm doing, is it proportional to the number of squares? Area of the square? Yes. Agar jada karte to jada jada bharta ja raha hai. So these numbers or points are directly proportional. The number of points which are inside the circle is directly proportional to the area of the circle. The number of points which are inside the square is directly proportional to the area of the square. Now if I say the radius of the circle is r symbolically, so what would be the area of the circle, quarter circle? Please aap bataiye. If the radius of this quarter circle is equal to r, what would be the area of this quarter circle? Please.
Pi r square by 4,
ma'am. Pi r square by 4.
Pi r square by 4. I was very unhappy when Prithviraj told me the answer. Why? Because every time he is telling the answer. So I was thinking probably the whole class is going to keep quiet. But I was wrong. Immediately I heard Ambika and Riya answering. So all of us know, please do not hesitate. If there is nothing going to happen, even if I am wrong. But take the courage, leave all your inhibition and please answer. The moment you answer, do you feel good about the fact that you have answered? आपको जब आप आंसर करते हो आपको अच्छा लगता है कि नहीं लगता है अपने आप को कोई कुछ बोले नहीं बोले आपको अच्छा लगता है कि नहीं
मैम लगता है
इसलिए दैट इज द रिवॉर्ड ऑफ आंसरिंग कोई आपको प्रेजेंट दे प्राइज दे वो उसके लिए वेट नहीं करना है अगर आपको कुछ आता है आप बोलने में कुछ भी ये खराबी नहीं है इनफैक्ट यू आर गेनिंग अ लॉट यू आर गेनिंग सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस You are feeling happy about it. You are feeling that, yes, I am being noticed. And that feeling itself is a plus point for all students to answer. I want all of you to answer, including Prithviraj. I am not saying Prithviraj should not answer. He is answering consistently all the 5 days. And we are really very, very appreciative about it. So hearty congratulations to Prithviraj. And I want to say hearty congratulations to everyone that is present over here. So please open your mouth, right? Okay, so you told me that NC is directly proportional to pi r squared by 4. Okay, proportional sign kaise likhta hai? Aapko pata hai. Toh aap likh lijiye NC proportional to pi r squared by 4. And think square ka area kitna hai? Yahan pe the length of this square, breadth of this square is how much? And therefore the area of the square is how much?
1800.
No, don't tell in numbers. अगर R अपना circle का radius हो, आप अपना ये picture को देखिए, तो आपका square का area कितना होगा? अगर आपका radius R है, तो square का area कितना होगा?
R square में.
Length square. Very good. Length square. So length कितना है यहाँ पे? यहाँ पे मेरा. मेरे पिक्चर में लेंथ कितना है रेडियस इज आर सो लेंथ कितना है बोलो 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 प्लीज सबको आता है यस आर एंड देयरफॉर द एरिया इज इक्विवेलेंट टू आर स्क्वायर्ड यू जस्ट नाउ टोल्ड मी लेंथ स्क्वायर्ड इफ लेंथ इज आर सो एरिया विल बी आर स्क्वायर्ड देयरफॉर एन एस इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर स्क्वायर्ड अग्रीड ओके इसका रेशियो ले लीजिए प्रोपोर्शनल माने मुझे इक्वल नहीं है प्रोपोर्शनल डजंट मीन इक्वल सिंस आई डोंट नो द प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी कांस्टेंट मैं आपको बोल रही हूं आप रेशियो लीजिए एनसी बाई एन एस वुड बी इक्वल इन टू आप लिखिए एनसी बाई एन एस वुड बी इक्वल इन टू वॉट यू सेड एनसी बेटा बोलो
मैम पाई बाय फोर
एक्सलेंट एंड आई एम एक्सट्रीमली हैप्पी सो यू हैव रियलाइज्ड दैट इट इज इक्वल टू पाई बाय फोर एनसी बाय एनएस इज इक्वल टू पाई बाय फोर ठीक है समबडी टोल्ड मी जीवन को टोल्ड मी जस्ट नाउ बट आई एम श्योर एवरीबॉडी हैज फाउंड आउट यू आर बीटिंग सो यू आर डेफिनेटली टेलिंग द आंसर टू योरसेल्फ इफ नॉट लाउडली सो एक्सट्रीमली वंडरफुल Now you have a relation NC by NS is equivalent to pi by 4. My next question is, pi ke arth kya hua hai? Kaun bolega? What is pi? Malum hai, sabko malum hai. Yesterday itself you were asking, sir, pi ka number 3.14 hai ki aur jyada hai. And ma'am very beautifully showed us that yes, it can be found out up to 16 digits and she gave us the number. So what is the meaning of pi? Yes, it is 3.1415 da-da-da-da-da-da-da. I don't remember the numbers and therefore I will not say. Or you can say it is 22 by 7. Ma'am, mujhe kal 16 digits tak dikhaye hain. But can you tell me that is there any other digits after the 16th digit? Is it 7? There is a 17th digit, 18th digit or is it 0? It stops over there.
Ma'am, it's an irrational number.
it is an irrational number and therefore it will not stop. So 22 by 7, agar hum main try, I found, want to find out the decimal point, it will be a recurring number. It will not stop. So it has many, 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 many points. Do you have a formula how you can find out, other than 22 by 7, which somebody has told us? Do you have a formula how to find out the value of pi? How can I find out the value of pi? अगर मैं आपको पूछूं कि मुझे पाए निकालना है, कैसे निकालूं, तो आप क्या बोलेंगे?
मैम रेशियो नहीं कर सकते?
हाँ, रेशियो किस किस का?
मैम सर्कमफेरेंस सर्कल का टू द डायमीटर ऑफ सर्कल.
एक्सीलेंट, ब्यूटीफुल, आई एम एक्सट्रीमली हैप्पी. जीवन, कीप इट अप. यस, यू कैन फाइंड आउट फ्रॉम द सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ अ सर्कल डिवाइडेड बाय डायमीटर. तो आपके पास क्वार्टर ऑफ अ सर्कल है और रेडियस है, तो आप सर्कमफेरेंस भी निकाल सकते हो, डायमीटर भी निकाल सकते हो और पाई निकाल सकते हो, एक मेथड. बट ये फॉर्म्यूला है क्या? इज दिस, मुझे सर्कमफेरेंस निकालना है, मैं किसमें सर्कमफेरेंस निकालूं? तो आप एक आइडिया दीजिए, मुझे सर्कमफेरेंस निकालनी है, वो एक कर्व है, तो मैं लेंथ ऑफ द सर्कमफेरेंस कैसे निकालूं? प्लीज बोलिए. एवरीथिंग दैट यू से इज करेक्ट, सो डोंट हेजिटेट टू आंसर. सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ अ सर्कल निकालने में थोड़ा तकलीफ होती है, क्योंकि हमारा स्केल तो स्ट्रेट होता है, वो कर्व में कैसे निकालेंगे? तो आप कुछ सजेस्ट कीजिए कैसे निकालूं.
मैम 2πr/4
मैं क्वेश्चन बोल रही हूँ, मैं पूछ रही हूँ. Somebody told me that for finding out pi, find out the circumference, find out the diameter, the ratio of the circumference divided by diameter will give me pi. It is perfectly correct. पर मैं अभी पूछ रही हूँ, आप बोल तो दिए कि सर्कम्फ्रेंस निकालिए, डायमीटर निकालिए, मैं अभी बोल रही हूँ आप सर्कम्फ्रेंस कैसे निकालेंगे? पार्डन,
May I join and intervene?
Yes, please. Everybody is allowed to answer. Everyone, including me. So I can also answer.
I will do an experiment.
Yes.
I will take a head, put it along the circumference, and then I will take a meter rod, and I will find the length of the thread which actually covers the circumference.
Okay. So sir and is telling us very tactfully, I will take a thread, I will keep it in the circumference, along the circumference. That means I will push it a little so that it is matching the circumference. Take that thread, go to a scale and measure the length. Therefore, I will find out the circumference. I said, yes, it will be okay, but it will not be perfect. My answer is, it is fine. If I want to find out by that method, it is okay, but it will definitely not be absolutely correct. Will it be absolutely correct? आर्क में सर्कल थ्रेड रखना इज नॉट अ इजी जोक. वो जरूर कुछ कर्व होंगे, टॉट नहीं होंगे. अगर वो रोप को टॉट नहीं कर पाओगे तो लेंथ में थोड़ा एरर होगा ही. सो दैट विल गिव अस अ मेथड, बट डेफिनेटली देयर विल बी सम अदर मेथड. यूजुअली फॉर फाइंडिंग आउट पाई देयर इज नो स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड फॉर्म्यूला फॉर मी टू कैलकुलेट पाई. इसीलिए मैं अभी और कुछ करके आपको बता रही हूं पाई हम कैसे निकाल सकते हैं. मुझे ये रैंडम पॉइंट जनरेट करना आता है, तंबोला का नंबर लेके मैं पॉइंट जनरेट कर सकती हूँ. अगर मैं पॉइंट जनरेट कर सकती हूँ और मैं देखी हूँ अभी एनसी बाई एन एस इज इक्वल टू पाई बाई फोर, एनसी में नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स इन द सर्कल काउंट कर पाऊंगी एक्यूरेटली, एनएस में एक्यूरेटली काउंट कर पाऊंगी कितने पॉइंट्स है स्क्वायर में. सो ये एक्यूरेट नंबर्स होंगे. These two ratio of this number is equal to pi by 4. तो मैं पाई कैसे निकाल पाऊंगी?
मैं may I share my screen with you? May I share my screen?
Yes, please, sir.
I'll do that and then I'll show you something.
Okay, so sir is going to explain it to us, and it will be very nice. So please watch.
So my screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
So what I had done when ma'am was actually talking about all these things, I did a spreadsheet actually.
Okay.
and in that spreadsheet I made A and B columns as X okay. and Y columns.
Okay.
And after that, what I did was, in the C column, I calculated X square plus Y square.
Okay.
And then I, in the next column, I calculated the radius.
Okay.
Which was, there were some numbers which were greater than 90 and there were certain numbers which were less than 90.
Very good.
And I used conditional formatting to show which numbers yes. are greater than 90 and which are not. So in this fashion, I counted the numbers.
Yes.
And then I also drew a chart in mm-hmm. which I tried to show where the numbers are sitting. So very what good. I learned in the last 4 or 5 days, I tried to apply that on this spreadsheet.
Fantastic.
And then,
fantastic. So now did you see the advantage of using an Excel sheet?
Yeah, I
hope sir, there was a wonderful way of calculating the number of points which is inside the circle and number of points which are totally in the square. From those 2 points, what else? Sir is continuing. Did you see the Excel sheet ka charm? Yeah, charm?
Yes, that is the magic of the spreadsheet.
Did you follow? Did you follow, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, अभी मुझे अगर पाए निकालना है ऐसे मैं खूब सारा पॉइंट ले लूं और मुझे कितने पॉइंट सर्कल के अंदर है और कितने पॉइंट स्क्वायर के अंदर है वो सिर्फ काउंट कर दूं, मुझे काउंट करने की भी जरूरत नहीं है. सर जस्ट नाउ टोल्ड अस दैट ही यूज्ड अ पर्टिकुलर कंडीशन इफ स्टेटमेंट एंड देन ही फाउंड आउट. हम सबको पता है इफ दिस इज ट्रू देन यू गिव मी दिस आंसर, इफ नॉट यू गिव मी दिस आंसर. ये कंडीशन अपने को पता है एक्सेल शीट में ये कंडीशन होता है. तो उस कंडीशन से सर इमीडिएटली काउंट करके बता पाए कि कितने सारे पॉइंट सर्कल में है और टोटली कितने पॉइंट है. सिंस ही नोज दिस रेशियो पाई बाई 4 इज इक्वल टू एन सी बाई एन एस, देयरफॉर पाई शुड बी इक्वल टू 4 टाइम्स एन सी बाई एन एस. एन सी बाई एन एस आपको पता है, अगर आप 4 मल्टीप्लाई कर देंगे तो पाई का आंसर मिल जाएगा. यस और नो? यस और नो?
यस मैम.
आई यू सी द जॉय ऑफ गेटिंग अ वैल्यू विदाउट नोइंग एनी पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मूला. हमें कुछ फॉर्मूला कुछ नहीं पता है. वी आर चिल्ड्रन, वी आर इनोसेंट, वी हैव मेनी क्वेश्चंस इन आवर माइंड, वी वांट टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन दैट वी आर हैविंग. आई वांट टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ पाई. So, हम गेम के खेल सकते हैं, वो गेम से भी कर पाएंगे. अगर हम स्मार्ट हैं तो गेम ये नहीं करना है, मुझे वो गेम एक्सेल शीट में करना है. सो व्हेन आई वाज टेलिंग यू टू मेक पॉइंट्स ऑन अ प्लेन शीट और अ ग्राफ शीट, सर वाज डूइंग दैट सेम थिंग इन दिस एक्सेल शीट एंड ही केम टू द आंसर क्विकली. फायदा क्या है एक्सेल शीट में, हम 20 पॉइंट्स करने में कितने सारे टाइम लगा लिए. अगर हम एक्सेल शीट यूज करेंगे तो हम थाउजेंड्स मिलियंस ऑफ पॉइंट्स बहुत फ्रैक्शन ऑफ अ मिनट में भी कर सकते हैं. वो कैसे करेंगे वी विल, आई वांट यू टू डू इट, आई विल नॉट टेल यू. सर हैज डन इट, आई वांट यू टू डू इट. सो दैट इज हाउ वी कैन फाइंड आउट. नो अभी सर जस्ट वन
मिनट.
ओके सर.
सो व्हाट आई डिड वाज आफ्टर दैट आई कैलकुलेटेड द एरिया.
ओके.
आई होप यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन. Hmm. And after that, I calculated the exact area of a circle with radius 90. Okay. And then I also tried to calculate what is the percentage error. And it turns out to be about 4.5%.
Fantastic. So now you are doing an experiment. And from that experiment, you are finding out the value of pi. You are also calculating the error in that particular experiment and telling me that the pi is equivalent to this much plus or minus 4%. Isn't it fantastic? Random between. So somebody is now showing me that there is a command and it is all inbuilt, and from that you can generate points. So I'm extremely grateful to all the participants who are paying attention and giving me ideas as to how I can find out the value of pi using Excel sheet. Fantastic. So I want to, before we go away from this, please calculate the time. Yes,
ma'am,
sir.
May I say one thing?
Yes, sir.
I just want to thank you for allowing me to come in between. Great. Thank you very much.
Sir, I am now taking the advantage of gaining knowledge from you. So I should be saying thank you to you. Thanks a lot, sir. Extremely wonderful. And I'm very happy that everybody is trying to participate. Now, from your data, somebody told 15, some told 16, some told etc. So NC aapko pata hai, NS aapko pata hai. Pi aap nikal ke mujhe bataiye. NC by NS multiplied by 4 will give you the value of pi in your experiment. Aap nikal ke mujhe bataiye, please. Jaldi, calculator aapke paas hai. Mera to answer 3 aaya. 15 points inside the circle, 20 points in the square. So 15 by 20 is 3 by 4 multiplied by 4 will give me 3. Therefore, my value of pi is 3. Aap logon ka kya nikla? Sapna ma'am is showing me 2.6. Very good. Very good. Bataiye, bataiye please. Sabka pa ek number hona chahiye. Aap log calculate. Haan. Pardon? 3.6? 3.15. 3. Very good. Very good. 3. Yes? 2.8. Very good. 2.8. Some more. Jitne bache hain, sabke paas ek ek number hoga. So, abhi main dekh rahi hoon, jitne answers aapko mujhe mila hai, all the numbers are changing from 2.6 to 3. So, हमारा जो कैलकुलेशन हुआ हम जो गेम खेले अभी उसमें से पाए निकाले पर ऑल ऑफ अस डिड नॉट गेट द सेम पाए बिकॉज ऑफ सर्टन एरर एंड देयरफॉर इन आवर वैल्यू वी हैव सम अनसर्टेनिटी वी मस्ट मेजर द अनसर्टेनिटी ओके तो आप अनसर्टेनिटी अगर मेजर करना चाहोगे तो कैसे करोगे मैं बताती हूँ जितने वेरी गुड सो ऑल ऑफ देम आर शोइंग 3.1 3.2 3.2.8 2.6 कीप इट अप Keep the numbers over here. I'm not collecting the numbers to give you any data. But then luckily all of you are getting numbers close to 3. 2.6, 2.8, 2.9, 3.1, 3.2 is all very close to 3. Therefore pi is somewhere close to 3. Somewhere close to 3. But not exactly 3.14. Kyun ho gaya? Ye mujhe error itna jyada kyun hai? Aap mujhe samjhaiye. क्यों मुझे इतना एरर मिल रहा है हाउ कैन आई इंप्रूव माई सिचुएशन मैं क्या करने से मुझे 3.14 मिलेगा कि 3.13 मिलेगा 3.12 मिलेगा इतना ज्यादा एरर नहीं मिलेगा क्या कर सकती हूं प्लीज आंसर आपको मालूम है और मुझे भी मालूम है कि आपको मालूम है अभी मैं सर को नहीं अलाउ करूंगी आंसर करने के लिए मुझे बच्चों के आंसर चाहिए मैं सपना मैडम की आंसर भी नहीं ले रही हूं मैं बच्चों से आंसर लेना चाहती हूं क्या करने से मुझे ये वैल्यू अच्छा मिलेगा मैं कितने पॉइंट्स ली कितने पॉइंट्स लिए हम लोग टोटली कितने पॉइंट्स लिए बोलिए प्लीज 20 sufficient to cover the area of my square and the circle? Not really. Okay, तो मैं एक assumption लिया कि हाँ ये छोटे number भी proportional होगा. Yes, it will be proportional. पर अगर मैं ये इसको अच्छे अच्छे से अच्छे करना चाहती हूँ, तो क्या कर पाऊँगी? Firstly, we have to accurately draw on the graph paper. Very good. Then we must have large number of trials. Somebody is giving me, showing me the answer. And both of them are perfectly correct. First error we did, I said you do an approximate circle, which was not true. It may not be a perfect circle. Okay, that quarter of a circle may not be perfect, kyunki aap free hand draw kiye. Secondly, hum bahut kam points liye. Agar hum achha point lete, khub sare point lete, to hamara number aur bhi achha hua tha. Dekhenge hum sachche hai ki nahi. We will see it ourselves. To abhi ye suggestions hai, कि खूब सारा पॉइंट लो और अच्छे से सर्कल बनाओ तो फिर आपको अच्छे आंसर मिलेंगे पाई विल बी वेरी क्लोज टू 3.14 वी वांट टू सी दैट अभी हम हाथ में जो करना चाहते थे इट इज टेकिंग वेरी लॉन्ग देयरफॉर आई वांट यू टू टेक आउट योर एक्सेल शीट एंड देन वी विल डू इट इन एक्सेल विलिंग आर यू विलिंग
यस मैम
यस Yes, I want to share my Excel sheet. I want all of you to take out your Excel sheet and then do. Oh no, I am not able to share. One second. Kya hua? I want to share my Excel sheet. I'm getting confused. I don't know how to share. I will first open the Excel sheet in the desktop. I cannot. Once the Excel sheet is becoming full large, I'm not able to. Shift, Alter, Enter. Okay. Now I have to open my PPT. I don't want to share. I want to open my Excel. Is it visible? It's not visible. It is full screen, so I can't see anything else. If I minimize it, it becomes a button. I'm not able to open it. If I minimize, okay. After minimizing, I should share. I'm trying, sir. I don't know. Always getting into some trouble trying to share. Share hua kya?
No. It has been shared now. Now
it has been
shared. You open the Excel sheet now.
I've opened mine. Dikha?
Yes.
It is visible? Okay. Now, thank you so much. I'm really sorry because every time I'm getting into this problem, I'm not able to open or share my things. So, thank you for helping me. Okay, now, aapko bachon ko dikh raha hai kya? Excel sheet dikh raha hai?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, in the first column, first mujhe kya karna hai? Circle draw karna hai. Circle draw karne ke liye, I asked you to mark it from 0 to 90. Can you tell me why I asked you to mark it from 0 to 90? Any one of you? Mere paas jo number the, wo number kitne tak the? Tambola mein jo number hota hai, wo kitne tak hota hai?
90.
Main number, tambola ki number mein kar rahi thi, isiliye main aapko 90 tak likha hai. Par agar main Excel sheet mein karna chahungi, ऐसे कुछ भी नहीं है. I can choose any number. The radius of my circle can be 10, 20, 30, 2, 3, 4, 300, 400 million, whatever I wish. There is no restriction. So, अभी मुझे अगर circle बनानी है, तो उसका radius जो मुझे चाहिए, जो मुझे खुशी होती है, वो number मैं choose कर सकती हूँ. Just to have similarity between what I did, मैं अभी R को 90 लिखी हूँ. But it is not necessary for you to make it 90. तो आप लिखिए आपका रेडियस कितना बड़ा होना चाहिए. R करके एक कॉलम में लिख लीजिए. यू कैन जस्ट टाइप R और नेक्स्ट सेल में आप एक नंबर लिखिए जो आपको ठीक लगता है वैसा नंबर लिखिए. यू कैन राइट एनी नंबर यू विश. हुआ क्या? आप प्लीज आंसर करोगे तो मुझे पता चलेगा कि हो रहा होता है कि नहीं. नहीं आई एम गेटिंग आई शुड नॉट बी वेटिंग इनडेफिनेटली क्योंकि हम थोड़ा प्रोग्रेस करेंगे. विद इन दैट स्टिपुलेटेड टाइम आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ पाई बाय दिस मेथड. व्हाट इज दिस मेथड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इट अ लिटिल लेटर. ओके आर इज इक्वल टू व्हाट डिड यू राइट यस और नो. अभी मैं यहाँ पे लिखी हूँ R इज इक्वल टू 90 मेरे हिसाब से, आप जो पसंद करते हैं वो लिख लीजिए, हाँ कि नहीं बोलिए। अच्छा नेक्स्ट, एक कॉलम, हम एक कॉलम में कुछ नंबर लिखना चाहते हैं, क्या नंबर लिखेंगे? एवरी टाइम यू वांट टू वर्क इन द एक्सेल यू शुड हैव योर प्रॉब्लम इन योर हेड, ओनली देन यू कैन वर्क, नहीं तो हम कहाँ जाएंगे क्या करेंगे कुछ पता नहीं चलेगा। सर वेरी नाइसली एक्सप्रेस्ड इट इन स्टेटमेंट्स कि ये भी करना है ये भी करना है, ऐसे करोगे तब जाके हमें सॉल्यूशन कुछ मिलेगा। तो क्या करना है, मैं समझा रही हूँ, मुझे एक सर्कल ड्रॉ करना है, ये ब्लू वाला क्वार्टर ऑफ अ सर्कल मैं ड्रॉ करना चाहती हूँ। कैसे ड्रॉ करूं, आपके पास ड्रॉ नहीं हुआ है, आपको ड्रॉ करना है। कैसे करना है, ये क्वार्टर ऑफ अ सर्कल में अगर मैं एक्स एक्सिस से वाई एक्सिस तक जाऊं तो मुझे कितना एंगल चाहिए, व्हाट इज द एंगल एट द सेंटर ऑफ अ क्वार्टर ऑफ अ सर्कल, बोलिए प्लीज। 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 90 मुझे 90 डिग्रीज में एक सर्कल ड्रॉ करना है, सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ द सर्कल ड्रॉ करना है। जैसे मैं ब्लू कलर एक ड्रॉ कर चुकी हूँ, तो मैं एक 1 डिग्री, 2 डिग्री, 3 डिग्री, 4 डिग्री ऐसे एक्स एक्सिस से वाई एक्सिस जाने के लिए मुझे 90 डिग्रीज चाहिए। तो मैं फर्स्ट कॉलम में वो डिग्रीज लिखती हूँ। कैसे लिखूंगी? 1, 2, 3, 4 ऐसे लिखूंगी अप टू 90 डिग्रीज। मैं दिखा रही हूँ हाउ टू राइट। यू विल फर्स्ट राइट इन एनी कॉलम यू विश। वहां ऊपर एक लिखिए थीटा, इफ यू लाइक टू कॉल दैट एंगल थीटा। यू लाइक टू राइट एनीथिंग यू राइट। एंड ये डिग्रीज में है तो फिर डिग्रीज। जब भी आप लिखोगे कुछ, अगर आप एक हेडिंग दोगे, बाद में 10 साल के बाद अगर खोलोगे अपना एक्सेल, तो आपको पता चल जाएगा ये एक्सेस में, ये कॉलम में क्या लिखा है, वो कॉलम में क्या लिखा है। हम सब एक्सपेरिमेंट में एक हेडिंग लिखते हैं, तो हमारा ये वाला एक्सपेरिमेंट में भी हेडिंग लिखना जरूरी है। तो यू हैव नाउ रिटन थीटा इन डिग्रीज। यहाँ पे एक लिखोगे, फिर नेक्स्ट 2 लिखोगे। ऐसे में कर करके 90 तक लिखूंगी तो मैं थक जाऊंगी, मुझे नहीं करना है। तो मैं क्या करूं, सिर्फ 2 डिग्री लिखा और इस दोनों को हाईलाइट करूंगी। हाईलाइट करने के बाद ये कोने में एक डॉट दिखता है, वहां पे अगर मेरा कर्सर लेती हूं तो वो दैट कर्सर विच वॉज एन एरो गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इंटू अ प्लस। जब वो प्लस हो जाएगा, उसको पकड़ के अगर मैं ड्रैग करूं तो ये पॉइंट्स माने शुरू हो जा रहे हैं, 20, 21, 31, 32, लाइक दैट इट इज गोइंग अप। जब वो 90 हो जाएगा मैं स्टॉप कर दूंगी। 90 से ज्यादा हो गया मैं कम कर रही हूँ, धीरे धीरे कम कर दिया, और 89 हो गया तो कम हो गया, बहुत कम हो गया तो मैं 90 कर दी। जब मैं 90 हुआ तो बंद कर दिया, और मुझे देखिए वो कॉलम में फिर 1, 2, 3, 4 सब कुछ लिख लिए, अपने आप लिख गया, मैं कुछ नहीं की, वो एक्सेल शीट अपने से कर लिया है। सो देर इज एन असिस्टेंट, रिमेम्बर व्हाट सर टोल्ड, देर इज एन असिस्टेंट हु इज विलिंग टू हेल्प अस एंड ही इज ऑलवेज एवर रेडी टू हेल्प मी, एंड देयरफॉर माय नंबर्स वेर ऑल फिल्ड। आई डिडंट हैव टू डू, व्हाट डिड आई डू, आई जस्ट रोट द 2 कंसेक्यूटिव नंबर्स 1 एंड 2, और उसको हाईलाइट करके वो कॉर्नर को गई, प्लस साइन हो गया। प्लस साइन को अगर क्या ड्रैग कर दोगे, you will get all the numbers. This is one way of filling up your cells automatically without any effort. Okay? आप ऐसे भी कर सकते हो। सपना मैम हमको और एक तरीका बताए थे। Yes, do you remember? What did she say? I want to write 1 and after that what should I do? One of you tell me. Okay, doesn't matter. You can think there are many, many possibilities, not just one. This is one possibility. You can follow this, or if you have any other better ideas, you can do it, but fill up your column 1 to 90. The moment you finish, then you tell me. Okay? मैं मुझे लिख रही हूँ R is equal into. जब मैं same cell में equal sign लिखूंगी, तो ये कुछ नहीं होगा. It will get printed whatever I want to write. आई वॉन्ट टू राइट आर इज इक्वल टू नेक्स्ट सेल को गई मुझे लगता है अभी 100 लेना चाहिए तो आई एम राइटिंग इट एज 100 डिपेंड्स अपॉन वॉट यू विश टू डू इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू एनी नंबर यू डू इट देर इज नो हार्म ओके सो नाउ आई हैव रिटन द एंगल्स आफ्टर द एंगल्स आई वॉन्ट टू पुट डॉट्स ऑन द सर्कम्फरेंस ओके मेरा सेंटर ओरिजिन 00 में है और मुझे डॉट्स लगाना है सो दैट इट फॉर्म्स द सर्कम्फरेंस ऑफ अ सर्कल अगर मुझे एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट और वाई कोऑर्डिनेट पता होता तब मैं डॉट लगा लेती और वो एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट वाई कोऑर्डिनेट कैसे मैं निकालू इफ द एंगल ऑफ द रेडियस विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू द एक्स एक्सिस इज इक्वल टू थीटा देन माय एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट विल बी इक्वल टू आर कॉस थीटा एंड द वाई कोऑर्डिनेट शुड बी इक्वल टू आर साइन थीटा आपको पोलर ग्राफ पता है अगर एंगल पता है रेडियस पता है तो यू कैन राइट एनी पॉइंट्स एज यू विश सो नाउ आई वांट टू राइट माय एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट ऑफ द सर्कम्फरेंस विच विल बी इक्वल टू आर कॉस थीटा इफ यू रिमेंबर सपना मैम हैड ऑलरेडी टोल्ड अस देयर इज अ सिंबल इफ आई वांट टू राइट थीटा आई कैन गो टू द सिंबल एंड देन प्रेस द सिंबल दैट थिंग व्हाट ओमेगा साइन देन आई कैन लुक एट वेयर थीटा इज रिटन आई एम क्लिकिंग ऑन थीटा Then I will say insert this theta. After inserting, please close this thing or menu and it gets closed. But automatically my number is written over here. X is equivalent to R cos theta. Now I want to write my Y coordinate for the circumference, which will be R sin theta. मुझे अभी आलसी आ रही है. कितने बार मैं लिखूं? So what I will do, I can only copy this. R cos theta, I will copy it. And then I will write near y, whatever the value is. But it is cos. I don't want cos. So cos ko sirf nikal ke, main sin likh sakti hoon. To ye ho gaya mera r sin theta. Okay? Now if I want to change that theta, which is written as q. Q is the English alphabet for theta. If I want to write it in the symbol, I should go to that insert column and then write. If I don't want to write, if q is fine with with me, let it be there, it doesn't matter. Okay, now please write your heading. Capital X is equal to R cos theta, capital Y is equal to R sin theta. Capital X and capital Y are my coordinates of the circumference. And I want you to please write it. Headings hardam likhna chahiye. Agar kuch galti hua, toh main usko correction bhi kar sakti hu. Insert gayi. I'm doing same thing whatever I had told you that time and I want all of you to kindly do it. Please do it. Yes, no. किसके पास है वो कर रहा है कर रहे हैं कि नहीं मुझे please बताइए.
Yes, ma'am, we are doing.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. I know that all of you do not have a computer and therefore you may not be able to do. But whatever few children are there, if you do it, later on you can share that knowledge with your friends. And the best way of learning is to teach. So when you teach your friend will learn, you will learn better. So it is double advantage. Therefore, please keep watching. If you don't have a computer, don't feel sad about it. You will have a computer very soon because you are studying your undergraduate. Now computer has become part and parcel of our education. Therefore, you will have a computer very soon. When you have, you can use it or share it with your friends. Share it in the college. You will have a PC in the college. Wherever you can get, you can try it out later on. So don't lose heart. Okay, now I have written, I want to write the X coordinate and the Y coordinate. What it is, R cos theta and R sin theta. Now, Excel sheet mein, ye theta mujhe radian mein hona chahiye. But I have written the theta values as 1, 2, 3, 4 degrees. So, isiliye, I learned this technique from Sapna ma'am's Excel work day before yesterday. She said there is an inbuilt command radian. I will use that and then write. I want to write the value of X. How will I go? Just below my X, I went to the cell. If I want to write a formula, I should start with an equal sign. So, I did an equal sign. Then I want to take the value of R. Value of R is written in D column first row. So I go to that point. I may write D1, but I don't want to write. मैं आलसी हूँ. मुझे सिर्फ कंप्यूटर में जो फैसिलिटी है उसी को लेके जाना है. So I go to this point and I click it. When I click it, automatically it is getting printed D1 in that cell wherever I should have written D1. Now ये D1 लिया और उसके बाद मुझे cos करना है. And there is a multiplication between R and cos theta. मल्टीप्लीकेशन का साइन सपना मैम हमें बताए हैं कि दैट इज अ स्टार एस्टेरिक, तो मैं एस्टेरिक लगाई. फिर मुझे कॉस करना है, सो सी ओ एस इज माय कॉस. अगर आपको नहीं पता है, आप जैसे भी सी टाइप करेंगे तो खूब सारे सी में जो फंक्शंस हैं वो एक मेनू में नीचे आ जाता है. मुझे कॉस चाहिए, मुझे लिखना नहीं चाहिए, तो इसको अगर वो ब्लू हो गया उसको मैं ये टैप करूं तो ऑटोमेटिकली दैट इज गेटिंग रिटन एज कॉस. नाउ कॉस रिटर्न्स द कोसाइन ऑफ एन एंगल, जो भी उसका मीनिंग है वो साइड में आ जाता है. सो अगर मैं कॉस करूंगी और उसके बाद जो भी लूंगी आर्ग्यूमेंट में वो दैट विल बी द कोसाइन ऑफ द एंगल. नाउ ये एंगल मुझे रेडियन में लेनी जरूरी है. तो फिर इफ आई डोंट टेक इट यू विल मेक अ मिस्टेक. सपोज आई डोंट नो, आई विल सिंपली से वन, देन यू सी ऑटोमेटिकली इट इज कमिंग प्लस नेम क्वेश्चन मार्क. ये नहीं आंसर नहीं आया तो फिर आई शुड गो बैक ओवर हियर एंड देन राइट ओवर हियर ओपन ब्रैकेट. देखो अभी कॉस ओपन ब्रैकेट नंबर क्लोज ब्रैकेट, इट शुड बी अ नंबर, इट शुड नॉट बी अ डिग्री, एंड देयरफॉर आई हैव टू कन्वर्ट दैट degree into a number. Radian is just a number. Okay? Therefore, I'm writing radian. Please look, the moment I wrote RA, it came RADIANS. Iska, agar main radians aise likh lo, to automatically radians ho jayega. So, therefore, I'm writing ANS. Mujhe kuch yaad rakhne ki jarurat nahi hai. Main agar karo, wo automatically mujhe hint de deta hai, ki aise karo, to ye hoga. Aise karo. So, radians agar likhoge, converts degrees to radians, उसमें आ गया तो automatically whatever degrees I take will automatically get converted into radians. मुझे क्या लेना चाहिए, ये one degree मुझे लेने का मन है, तो फिर I will ये radians के बाद एक bracket होगा, तो bracket किया, देखो radians bracket angle करो, तो angle कौन सा है, I went to this place, I tapped it, when I tap it, it is coming B column फोर्थ रो, ऑटोमेटिकली B4 आ गया. फिर उसके बाद जब भी अगर एक ब्रैकेट खोलोगे तो यू मस्ट क्लोज द ब्रैकेट. इफ यू डोंट क्लोज द ब्रैकेट कंप्यूटर आपको हाउल करेगा, ऐसे क्यों कर रहे हो, करो नहीं तो गलती है, मैं ठीक कर दूं, कुछ कुछ बोल देगा. मुझे मालूम है इसीलिए मैं ब्रैकेट क्लोज कर दिया, ये रेड वाला ब्रैकेट क्लोज कर दिया पर ब्लैक वाला ब्रैकेट क्लोज नहीं किया है, तो मुझे और एक ब्रैकेट देना पड़ेगा. अभी एक ब्लैक वाला ब्रैकेट क्लोज हो गया. जब मैं लिख चुकी हूं उसके बाद अगर एंटर कर दूंगी तो मेरा नंबर ऑटोमेटिकली आ गया, तो मेरा नंबर आ गया 99.98477, 5 digit आफ्टर डेसिमल पॉइंट, दैट इज द फॉर्मेट. ओके, जो कंप्यूटर का फॉर्मेट है वो ऑटोमेटिकली आ गया, मैं कुछ नहीं की हूं, इतने सारे डिजिट्स आ गए और मेरा वैल्यू होना चाहिए आर कॉस 1 should be very close to 100. It is a number very close to 100. So I am correct. Okay. Now similarly, I will write over here. What will I write? I should write R sine theta. Same process. I start with equal sign. Then I will go to R, which is 100. Then I will do into. Then I will write sine. Then I will open the bracket. Write radians. Because it is in degrees, I will write radians. Then I will open the bracket. And I will go to 1. Automatically it is written 1. Then I will close the bracket. Close the bracket once again because I will otherwise make an error. Agar aap error karoge bhi, to kuch chinta nahi hai. It will automatically get reflected in your answer. And from that you can make out there is some error. I have to correct it. Okay? Agar aap dekhna chahoge, to main ek bracket nikal di. Agar main enter kar do, we found a typo in your formula and tried to correct it. Correction do bracket kar diya. Do you want to accept this correction? Main aaram se bolungi haan. To agar main mistake bhi kar di, kuch hone wala nahi hai. Computer ka mujhe assistance bahut badhiya sa mil jata hai. Okay? Now I want to, don't want to keep so many digits. मुझे इतने सारे digits रखना नहीं है. एक 1 degree का मैं both x coordinate, y coordinate ले चुकी हूँ. मुझे इतने सारे digits रखने नहीं है. I want to decrease the digit. वो facility भी है. तो first I highlighted, then I am going to the opening the ribbon. Okay, where is it? Home को गई. Home में यहाँ पे अगर देखोगे 0.0.00 उसको कमा सकते हो. यहाँ पे 0.00.00 उसको बढ़ा सकते हो. मुझे कुछ करना है, कमाना है, बढ़ाना है, मुझे नहीं मालूम. मैं इसको प्रेस किया, वो बढ़ रहा है. देखो, तो फिर मैं इसको जाऊंगी और कमाना शुरू कर दूंगी. कल मैडम मुझे हमें दिखा रहे थे, डिपेंड्स अपॉन हाउ मेनी डिजिट्स यू वांट टू कीप. आई वांट टू कीप ओनली 1 digit एंड देयरफॉर आई वेंट टू keep on decreasing the number of digits. It got decreased. After decreasing, what will I do? I want to write for 2 degrees, 3 degrees, up to 90 degrees. But I'm not going to do it. My assistant will help me. How will it help me? I highlighted both these columns. I went to this cell corner. There is a dot. I have to convert this dot into a plus sign, or it will remain as a dot. Now I will drag it. The moment I pressed my button, left button, the arrow got converted into a plus sign. Now I'm going to pull it and fill up my columns up to 90 degrees. अगर ज्यादा हो गया तो हम घटा सकते हैं. मुझे 90 तक चाहिए तो फिर मैं 90 तक भर दी. Okay. Now I have got an error. अब देखो error हो गया तो मुझे immediately पता चल गया मैं क्या गलती की हूँ. क्या गलती की हूँ? I had taken 100, यहाँ पे 100, यहाँ 1.7 perfectly आया. Please सुनो, देखो, I purposely made the mistake. यहाँ पे मेरा formula D2 into cos radians B5. D2 कहाँ पे है? यहाँ पे है. ये zero. जब भी हम ऐसे ये क्या drag करते हैं, all the successive numbers keep coming. तो यहाँ पे ये number आया और इसके नीचे ये नंबर आना चाहिए, पर इसमें कुछ है ही नहीं, इसीलिए वो 0-0 दिखा रहा है. आई हैव टू टेक आर कंटिन्यूअसली. सिंस आई हैव टू टेक आर कंटिन्यूअसली, प्लीज वॉच व्हाट आई एम डूइंग. मैम हैज ऑलरेडी टोल्ड अस, सर हैज ऑलरेडी टोल्ड अस दैट इफ आई एम गोइंग टू टेक वन वैल्यू कॉन्स्टेंट, आई डोंट वॉन्ट इट टू चेंज. इट शुड नॉट गो फ्रॉम दिस सेल टू दिस सेल. आई हैव टू राइट अ डॉलर. देयरफॉर आई विल राइट ओवर हियर डॉलर बी डॉलर एस. डॉलर आपको कहाँ पे है दिखेंगे कीबोर्ड में. अब देखिए यहाँ पे भी ये मिस्टेक है, आपको डॉलर लिखना है और यहाँ पे भी डॉलर लिखना है. आई पर्पसली डिड इट फॉर यू टू रियलाइज कहाँ पे डॉलर लिखना है, कहाँ पे डॉलर नहीं लिखना है. B4 में डॉलर नहीं लिखना है क्योंकि ये है B4. मुझे फिर बाद में 2 degrees चाहिए विच इज B5. इफ आई वॉन्ट 4 degrees इट विल बी B7. वो सीरियली बढ़ता जाएगा. मुझे उसको डॉलर कर दूंगी तो वो एवरी टाइम इट विल टेक 1111. आई डोंट वांट इट, बट एवरी टाइम आई वांट टू टेक आर एंड आर इज इक्वल टू 100. देयरफॉर आई हैव टू टेक द सेम आर इन ऑल माय कॉलम्स. हेंस फॉर D1 आई शुड राइट डॉलर डी डॉलर 1. सो वंस आई डू दैट इट विल नॉट करेक्ट बाय इटसेल्फ. आई विल गो टू दैट लाइन वेयर एवर द करेक्शन वॉज मेड. नाउ इफ आई ड्रैग इट, इट विल कम करेक्टली बिकॉज आई हैव टेकन the absolute reference for R and I'm sorry, yes, and relative reference for B's for my values of theta. Therefore, I get all my values which is required for X and Y. I'm stopping for 1 minute. I hope you have understood. I want you to do it. Please do it. Those of you who have the facility to do it, I'll stop for 1 minute. Please do it. If you have any questions, ask. Are you doing? Some of you may already be knowing it. If you know, you please do it quickly. If you can help your friends, please help your friends. There should be sharing and communication between the students so that they can learn from each other. Please do it if you can talk to each other by WhatsApp or whatever it is, or chat box. If you don't, cannot do it, please ask me. Please ask sir. Please ask Sapna ma'am. Please ask all those who are here. and take help. There is nothing to feel shy about. I don't know something, I will ask and I will learn it. Okay? So please now learn it and do it yourself. And if possible, I want to see it later. Now I'm sharing. So since I'm sharing, let me continue sharing. After that, because sharing for me is difficult. So after that, I will want you to share. Okay? Now, could you do it? Yes or no? Yes or no? Has yes. one child done it? I want somebody else to answer also. I want somebody else to answer also. बेटा रे हिम्मत करके अपने आप करना चाहिए अगर नहीं करोगे तो आज कल खत्म हो जाएगा उसके बाद आप भूल जाओगे आप कुछ भी नहीं कर पाओगे उसके बाद अगर कुछ नहीं किया अभी तो फिर यू विल फील लेजी यू विल नॉट लाइक टू डू इट बिकॉज यू डोंट नो हाउ टू प्रोसीड इफ यू स्टार्ट डूइंग इट टूडे और इफ यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड गुड इनफ देन यू विल बिल्ड अप कॉन्फिडेंस एंड यू विल बी एबल टू यूज एक्सेल विच इज अ फैंटास्टिक What software which is there in your computer, you don't have to pay money and buy, and you can use it for a variety of things. It is my sincere request. Please do it if you have your Excel sheet open. What? बोलो कुछ बोलो अभी नहीं तो कभी नहीं दैट्स इट आई एम वेटिंग फॉर यू टू डू इट सो प्लीज डू इट इफ यू हैव एनी डिफिकल्टी प्लीज आस्क वी आर देयर टू हेल्प यू कितना कुछ सर दिखाए हमें मैम दिखाए हमें अगर सब कुछ हम कर पाएंगे तो क्यों नहीं उससे भी ज्यादा कर पाएंगे तो क्यों नहीं तो कहीं से शुरू करना पड़ेगा इसीलिए मुझे बहुत मन है कि आज से शुरू करो अगर किया नहीं है पहले से अगर पहले से किया है तो अभी तक खत्म हो जाना चाहिए कि यस आई नो एंड आई कैन डू इट प्लीज ट्राई कुछ डिफिकल्ट पूछो हाँ
Ma'am, I can able to do all this, but I don't able to highlight the first column.
Highlight the first column. देखिए अब मैं क्या कर रही हूँ इसको आपका लेफ्ट प्रेस करना है लेफ्ट माउस है उसको प्रेस करना है और यहाँ पे अगर ड्रैग करोगे ऐसे तो ये हाईलाइट हो गया ठीक है अगर मुझे ये हाईलाइट करना है मैं हाथ छोड़ दी फिर इसको यहाँ पे रख के मैं प्रेस किया लेफ्ट बटन और ऐसे किया ड्रैग किया तो वो हाईलाइट हो गया अभी दो कॉलम हाईलाइट हो रहा है अभी एक कॉलम हाईलाइट हो रहा है मैं हाथ को थोड़ा सा इधर उधर मेरा टच स्क्रीन है तो फिर आई एम जस्ट मूविंग इट माय फिंगर टू स्लोली सो दैट इट गेट्स हाईलाइटेड सो इन योर कंप्यूटर आई एम नॉट श्योर हाउ इट कैन बी हाईलाइटेड बट ट्राई इट आउट लेफ्ट बटन यूज करो और ड्रैग करो तो हाईलाइट हो जाएगा Another way I'm telling you, for highlighting, go to this cell, press shift and arrow button, down arrow, it is getting highlighted. I am doing shift and down arrow, left, down arrow, it is getting highlighted. I am now doing shift, right button, my right is getting highlighted. I am doing shift, up button and it is, because it was highlighted, it is decreasing. When I go to zero highlight, then it will get up button. Highlighted. I want left button to be highlighted. First, the highlight part is getting deleted and then it is getting highlighted on the left hand side. Did you realize? This is another way of highlighting shift and arrows. Yeah, very good. This is how we learn from each other. So don't feel shy. You please ask if you have difficulty. We will all of us put our effort to Get a solution for that. Okay? Please do it. And now after highlighting, do the thing. Write the function. Start with an equal sign. Fill, convert the theta into radians and write the value of r cos theta for x axis, r sine theta for the y axis. And then you drag it for filling up for all the columns. And when you are dragging, If you don't put absolute reference wherever you are taking a constant value, then it will go from one cell to another. Last time I showed you, from 100 it was going to 0, then it went over here, then it went over here. When it goes to alphanumeric, it will ask you some hash name question mark. If it goes to some number, it will calculate something else. Okay, so I don't want it, then I must put a absolute reference, dollar dollar. वो करके फिर आप हाईलाइट करोगे ड्रैग करोगे देन यू विल बी एबल टू फिल अप दिस थिंग सेल्स प्लीज डू इट हुआ कि नहीं इन अ क्लासरूम व्हेन यू आर सिटिंग विथ योर फ्रेंड मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम इफ आई कांट अंडरस्टैंड आई विल लुक टू माय राइट और लेफ्ट एंड आस्क माय फ्रेंड क्या बोल रहे हैं मैम कुछ मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा है तो आपका फ्रेंड बता देता है कि ऐसे ऐसे हो रहा है ये हो रहा है तो वी आर लर्निंग फ्रॉम ईच अदर इन द क्लासरूम अनफॉर्चुनेटली दैट फैसिलिटी इज नॉट देयर नाउ यू एवरीबॉडी इज सिटिंग अलोन विद द पीसी देयर इज नो हेल्प माने इमीडिएट हेल्प इसीलिए आपको थोड़ा तकलीफ हो सकती है फिर भी वो तकलीफ को ओवरकम करना बहुत जरूरी है इसीलिए डोंट फील डिसहार्टेंड यू आस्क एंड देन यू फाइंड आउट If you feel, you can also chat with your friends and find out, oh, ma'am, ऐसे कर रहे हैं, ये बोल रहे हैं, मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा है. तो फिर you can ask your friend. And if you want, you can please ask me. I'm there.
Madam, may I intervene, please?
Yes, sir.
Madam, कई बार बच्चों को ना ये absolute और दूसरे reference की फाइल चलता, तो एक तरीका और है कि जो आपके पास number है, r cos theta वाला या r sin theta वाला, जैसे first वाला number है, उसमें आप right click करके फॉर्मेट सेल्स की ऑप्शन आती है
फॉर्मेट सेल्स
यस मैम
नंबर पे ले जाके आप वहां पर डेसिमल प्लेस वन पे कर करके ओके कर सकते हो तो फिर सारा हो जाएगा
अच्छा आई एम नॉट अवेयर ऑफ इट सर इज गिविंग सम अदर सजेशन If you can take that also, it is fine. Please take it.
अगर first number है किसी बच्चे का वहाँ पर आप right click करके तो वहाँ पर एक format cells की option आएगी.
Format cells मैं देखती हूँ. Format cells. हाँ format cells आई.
उसमें आप click करके number पे आप लिख कर दो.
हाँ नंबर पे है उसमें डेसिमल प्लेसेस हैं
वन कर दो वहाँ पर
हाँ
उसके बाद ओके कर दो सर आ जाएगा
अच्छा अच्छा वो एक डेसिमल प्लेस चाहिए तो दिस इज अनदर मेथड ओके सर आई हैव गॉट इट दिस इज फॉर्मेटिंग सेल माने आप जो नंबर लिख रहे हो वो ऑटोमेटिकली कितने पांच डिजिट आते थे आपके डेसिमल प्लेस के बाद अगर यू वॉन्ट ओनली वन डेसिमल प्लेस सो यू कैन गो टू फॉर्मेट सेल्स वहां पे जनरल नंबर करेंसी अकाउंटिंग डेट टाइम परसेंटेज फ्रैक्शन कुछ कुछ है आपका नंबर किस फॉर्मेट में होना चाहिए आपको अगर नंबर नंबर में चाहिए तो नंबर क्लिक करके डेसिमल पॉइंट्स कितने चाहिए 1, 2, 3, 4 वो भी लिख लीजिए एक अप एरो डाउन एरो है वहां पे यू कैन चेंज दैट सो आई कैन डू इट नाउ डेसिमल पॉइंट 1, 2, 3, 4 व्हाटएवर आई वांट नो आई वांट 1 सो आई एम क्लिकिंग दैट एरो So I want one, I will leave it as one. उसके बाद अगर ओके बोलो तो फिर इट विल बी रिटन एज 100.0 वन डेसिमल प्लेस ओके इट विल नॉट बी 99.9877743 वो जो हुआ था हमारा वैसे नहीं होगा दैट इज वॉट इज हैपनिंग हाउ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट योर नंबर्स इन विच फॉर्मैट वो नंबर फॉर्मैट सेल्स में हो जाता है Fantastic सर थैंक यू वेरी मच सर Yeah, but this will not tell you about absolute reference or relative reference के बारे में नहीं बोल रहा है Absolute reference माने एक ही number 100 है ये यहाँ पे भी होगा यहाँ पे भी होगा यहाँ पे भी लिखा चारों ओर लिखना होगा full column में पर एक ही place में लिखा है इसको मैं absolute reference बोल रही हूँ Okay, so that should be dollar dollar पर अगर 1, 2, 3, 4 ये column में भी है यहाँ cell में है 2 यहाँ पे है 3 यहाँ पे है 4 यहाँ पे है So here it should be R cos 1, here R cos 2, here R cos 3. So it should be running consecutively. When it is like that, it has to run. You don't have to do anything. Just write the cell, which is reference thing. Relative reference. And wo automatically ho jata hai. When I'm moving from here, if I'm writing 1 over here, and I want to write over here r cos 2, then automatically when I'm dragging, it will take that particular number from that row. So it will automatically happen. Don't write dollar.
Ma'am, may I come in for a minute?
Please. Yes, please.
See, if you are to keep this radius as absolute reference, what you should do is, जहां पे नंबर 100 लिखा है इस पे जाओ और इस सेल पे बैठ करके जस्ट F4 प्रेस करो एंड यू विल फाइंड F4 बिकम या F4 आई हैड गिवन इट माय इन माय प्रेजेंटेशन आल्सो
या नाउ लेट मी डू इट आई विल टेक आउट द डॉलर आई विल टेक आउट द डॉलर ओके देन आई विल गो ओवर हियर एंड F4
डोंट टेक आउट डॉलर फ्रॉम हियर यू जस्ट कीप D1 एज बट गो टू द सेल वेयर 100 इज सिटिंग
Where 100 is sitting, okay.
And then you press F4 for that actually.
F4 for that, okay. F4.
And then it will become what you call absolute reference.
No, no, sir, zero ho gaya. I think.
It works, in fact. Once again, I am repeating that what you need to do is, maine ye bataya bhi tha, aap एक सेल आप प्रेस कर लीजिएगा एक एडिशनल साइड में सेल प्रेस करिएगा
अच्छा यहाँ पे
या
सेल हाँ
और वहां पे जब ये प्रेस कर साइड में कोई सेल एक और एडिशनल खाली इसको अपने F4 प्रेस करो F4
ओके आई डिड F4 नहीं जीरो
नाउ इफ यू राइट से 100 इन इट राइट डाउन 100 इन इट
आफ्टर थिंक प्रेसिंग F4 आई विल राइट 100 ओवर हियर
राइट 100 इन इट
ओह यस Oh yes. So whichever is a constant, you
Actually,
first.
Actually, this press is a small button. Shortcut only. This is a shortcut.
Acha. So first, I will press. Think. Come to that cell. Press hand. Yes. I think F4. Then yes. write the number. Then yes. it will become constant wherever I want it.
Yes. Wherever you will take it, it will be constant then.
Acha. It will be a constant, and automatically this dollar will come.
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic!
And then so even this is another shortcut. You can do another thing also.
Yes,
you
sir.
Can, you know, here it is written F10 for example, D1, right? D1 is a cell, but you name it. Call it, say, radius. And the moment you name it, it will become absolute reference.
If I take, when I go to 100, I will go to name
D1, it. Then go to D1, that where the cell address is written.
Define name.
On the top corner below file, there is written D1. Below file, there is written D1.
This one.
Okay, go there.
Here. Refer to.
And D1. Just go to D1.
Here,
I mean,
this one.
Address. Yeah. In that cell here, D1 is written.
Okay.
Below file. And you just give it a name. And another name. Say radius.
Name is written over here. I will call it radius.
Yeah, you call it radius. I mean, but by going there.
And okay.
So I think this one people can try later. Let's proceed to the bed.
Okay, now we will undo that. I'm undoing it just to make things simple. But sir is giving you alternate ways of doing whatever you have done it over here. What are the other methods by which you can do it? Simply. Okay, so try all the other alternative ways. Whichever clicks, it's not necessary that you should remember everything. For me, I'm doing it like this, it works. If it is not very difficult, I can continue. If this is a difficult method, there is some other easier method, I should go for that. There are different routes to go to do a particular thing. And sir is showing you all the different paths through which you can do the same thing. Okay, so you can try it out later also if you wish. I wish you to want, I'm sorry, I'm very keen that you should complete it. Okay, now whoever has completed, I'm now telling you how to draw a graph. Okay, so I want x-axis is my x-axis. The y-coordinate is my y-axis. I want to write x and y and then plot these points for the circumference. Therefore, I'm highlighting this and highlighting all the xy coordinates up to 90 degrees. Then I'm going to insert. After I go to insert, I want to go draw a graph. So I go to charts and then I go to the scatter graph. scatter graph without any line, I will take this. With line, I will take this. With line and no dots, I will take this. If I want lines, straight lines between two points, I'll take this. Without any points, I will take this. So all those things are given to me. I wish to take points without any line. This is the usual pattern. And after that, you can draw the trend lines, etc. So I'm going to this one and plotting it. Did I get the circumference of the quarter of a circle? Yes, but it doesn't look like a circle. Why? Because my graph is a rectangle and what I'm drawing is inside a square. Since my graph is having a different shape, it is not looking like a quarter of a circle. Therefore, I'm now going to change this and make it a square. If I make it a square and I can drag it and make it. So what I'm doing, I'm just telling you, I went to this point. Then my arrow plus sign is getting changed to a arrow, double-headed arrow. You make it square by dragging it and whichever point it looks squarish, you stop over there. It's not looking perfectly square to me, my graph part. And therefore, I'm changing. Now, once I reorient my graph size, shape and size, I can show that radius equivalent to 100. I have a quarter of a circle circumference. So now my circle is ready. And automatically, this is my square because it is a graph paper. I don't have to do anything. This is my square that is required, which is inscribing the quarter of a circle. I have been able to draw the circle. Now I have to draw points which are random. And that is very, very important, which I need to just show it to you. And I'm sure you will be able to do. The Excel sheet itself has a random generator. Sir will talk a little more about the random generator, what type it is. I'm not going to explain it to you in detail. But I'm just teaching you how to draw the thing. And see what I'm doing. I want to move the graph up. Okay, it has come to some place. I want to move it up so that I can show you what exactly has to be done. So I'm now going to the edge. There is a plus sign. I'm holding it. Left, I'm pressing it. And then I'm shifting it to whichever place I feel convenient so that I can see. Okay, so this is how you can do. Right. Then you told me that I have to find out the X randomly, Y coordinate randomly for the points. Let those points be called as small X and small Y. That the circumference, I called it as capital X and capital Y. These point coordinates, I'm calling it as small X and small Y. We did it with the coin. Now I want the Excel sheet to do it for me. How will I do? There is a format. You can write, there is a function directly. Because I'm writing up, I want to take a function which I'm aware of. I did equal. Rand is the command. R-A-N-D, short for random, is the command. Okay. Now when I do rand and open bracket, close bracket, it will give me randomly some points. Some numbers, but this number will always be between 0 and 1. But I want random numbers from 0 and 100 because my radius is equivalent to 100. My square has a length equivalent to 100. All the points have to be inside the square means it has to be numbers from 0 to 100. For that, we have to do a slight modification. It is rand between, B-E-T, between. Please see, rand between returns a random number between the numbers you specify. So I can specify and I can, help will give you all this. If you have little doubt, go to help and find out. Since I know I have found out from help, I'm just telling it to you. So I can find out rand between, open bracket. My number should lie between 0 and 100. Therefore, I will write 0, 100. And then close bracket. The moment I have written the command, I will simply enter it and a number, random number will be generated. Now my random number is 96. Okay. I should have a random number for Y also, which I did from the coin. Again, I will simply copy. Look at me. I copy this. Control C is copy. I go over here and I do Control V paste. What I did, I copied the formula. I didn't write it once again. I copied it. Once I copy, the same formula is written. But since it is random number generator, it is generating every time I do enter, it is generating one fresh number. It is not going to remain the same. Now I have done it for x coordinate and y coordinate. Now I want to produce points, how many? Not 20, because my Excel sheet will help me to do a number of them very quickly. So I will definitely do some 500. I don't want to do 20. So, or let me say 200. So I will simply go over here, highlight both these points. If I want X and Y coordinate, see, I'm going fast. It is doing the thing, it is writing, but it is not visible. I want to do it, let us say 200. I'm looking at the serial number. I can also do it near the serial number. I've written it as 205, I will do. Okay, I don't know how many it is. So the last number is 206. On the serial number side on Y, first column I'm seeing. And this was started from 400. So 205 minus 4 is 201. So totally my points are 201. Okay, I'm writing this. What is this? This is the total number of points in the square. So this is my NS. NS is totally 201. Okay, did you understand? Yes, no? Yes, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. And do I have an X coordinate and Y coordinate? Yes. Yes. Okay. So now I want to draw it inside the circle. I am not going completely and then I'm doing it step by step so that you understand. I want all these points to be in my graph paper. It is not there in the graph paper. I want to add these points into my graph paper. Yesterday, ma'am told us, go to this graph and then you right click. You will say add format, select data. Okay, so I will select data. Which data I will select? I will add those data that I want, that I have generated now. So add all these datas. What data is that? The series name I will write. I will say call it as random points. They are random points. Okay. And then x-axis I want to write. Please check over here. X-axis, what are the values? I am not going to write that cell number, cell address. I'm doing a smart thing. I'm going to as first cell, then I am dragging it to highlight it. Since there are 200 numbers, I don't remember 203 or 205. So I just highlight it. The moment I highlight it, it says sheet number 2 factorial or exclamation mark, $G$4 to $G$206. That means it has told me that my X values range from this number to that number. That is done. If I do OK, it will get added. Now I want to add more. What do I want to add? No. Random number, why I have not added? I'm sorry. I didn't add the Y number. Sorry. Random points. OK. I go to X. I will highlight from top to bottom, bottom to top. It will do it correctly. It doesn't bother a thing whether you have highlighted or selected from top to bottom or bottom to top. I did it from bottom now. X is done. Now I will go to Y. I had forgotten to do this. So I will go over here and I will highlight Y. Y I can do from top to bottom. X I can do from bottom to top. It doesn't matter. It will write it always from the smallest to the highest number. Okay. When I'm doing highlighting also, it is coming over here. 203 rows have been highlighted in one column. Please look at the next block which is coming over here telling me how many have been highlighted. Now it has been highlighted, X coordinate and the Y coordinate. Therefore, I will do OK and automatically look at my graph. Hey, kya hua? It should have been pointed. Did you see all the points have been done on that graph? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
All yes, ma'am. 203 or 204 points are all there inside my square. 100 as to 100. So that this length is 100. This length is also 100. It is all there in the total square. How many numbers? I just now told you 200, 3, 4. And some of them are inside the circle. Rest of them are outside. I need to count how many points are inside the circle. For you to find out how many points are inside the circle, it would have been better for me to write some command over here so that the computer does the counting. I don't have to do the counting. Okay, now I'm teaching you how to do it. Now, if I consider this point, a particular point, its coordinates are x and y. Okay, so from the origin, what is this distance? This distance is square, this distance square is equivalent to x squared plus y squared. In think coordinate geometry, we have learned distance between two points. This coordinate is x and y. This coordinate is 0, 0. Therefore, this distance will be equivalent to x squared plus y squared square root. Or distance square will be equivalent to x squared plus y squared. So, this squared plus this squared will give me the distance from this point from the origin. Okay. If this distance is lesser than my radius square, then it is inside the circle. If this distance, this point if I'm taking, if this distance is greater than the radius square, then it is outside the circle. So if I give some command like this for the computer to understand what I'm asking, it will be able to tell me whether it is inside or outside. This is called an if condition. Okay, so I'm trying to write this if condition. I go to this block. I will have to write a function. So I'm writing equal and I want to write if. Therefore, I wrote if. The moment I write if, I have to put a bracket for it to tell me what I want to do. See, look at this. If is a logical test. I have to do a logical test. And if that test is true, then the value should be whatever is written over here, comma. If the test is false, then the value should be over here. That is what it is telling me. What is my logical test? I will say x squared, okay, plus y squared. I'm just writing the formula for you. Then I will substitute. Y squared should be greater than. If it is greater than r squared, okay, then what I want, comma, if it is greater than r squared, it is not inside the circle, so let it be 0. Otherwise, let it be equivalent to 1. So these are my values to tell me whether it is inside the circle or outside the circle. But I can't write x squared and y squared. I have to write the values of x squared and y squared, which is over here. Okay? So instead of x squared, I should write 68 into 68. Or the cell number G4 into G4. So that is how the function has to be written. You can't write the formula like you are writing in an algebraic equation. So I'm going to make that correction. I just wrote this for you to understand. Now I will say, I will write it in terms of the cell. So what I will write, I want this squared. So it is into this squared. I'm just tapping it plus this squared into this squared. Okay, I have written this. Now, if I write a plus sign anywhere, then it is necessary that you have to identify that term, which is the logical test, in a bracket. So, I have written it as a bracket and it should be greater than. Greater than what? It should be r squared. My r value is over here and it has to be a dollar. Okay. So, I'm writing b. I'm purposely writing it b so that I don't have to write the number. If I change anything, it will automatically go. I think it is changing means I don't have to write dollar probably. I will write it dollar for, okay. B is a constant, so I'm writing it as $B$1. Okay. Now this should be, what's happening? Okay. This should be, this whole term is the logical test. So to separate it out, I'm putting another bracket all throughout. Then it should be comma. Then it should be zero because it is outside. If it is true, false, then it will be one. You can write greater than or less than. You choose your logical test, whatever it is correctly, then it will be done. Okay. Now I did this and I will enter. not trying to type a formula when the first character is in equal or minus. Excel thinks it's a formula. It is a formula. There's a formula with this. There is a problem with this formula.
It's open bracket hold lagogi. स्टार्टिंग पे एक ओपन ब्रैकेट होल लगोगी अब तीन ब्रैकेट क्लोज कितनी है
इफ मैं बोल रहे हो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू माय थिंग आई थिंक आई विल जस्ट हैव अ लुक एट दिस एंड शो यू I'm showing you if open bracket G4 into G4. I did some gadbad. I went to sheet number 2 and did something. So I did some mistake. I think I will delete it off. I'll delete it off and then do it. I'm talking and doing something. No, I've deleted it. The logical test. Oh, it is writing some sheet. I think I need some help. I think I will go back. I'm doing some mistake over here. I will first delete it off. Some sheet from one sheet to another I'm moving. That is why. Huh. Now let me tell you. Okay, now these random numbers are changing. Can you see? I'm going to one block and then I'm doing delete and it is changing. Again, I'm doing delete. It is changing. Again, it is doing, I'm doing delete in this corner, in this cell. That means I'm generating 200 random points just by one click every now and then. Just by one click. Okay, now I think I will go to the previous one. I'm doing some mistake. I can realize it and show you over here. Then we'll go there once again. Okay, now here, oh, it's already 7 o'clock, Bhagawan. If F4 into F4 plus G4 into G4 is greater than 90 into 90, then you make it 0. Otherwise, you make it 1. That is my command that I have written over here. So, once I write this condition, it automatically says 52 squared plus 74 squared, it is inside the circle, so 1. But 79 squared is outside the circle, so it is 0. And therefore, it is telling me, sorry. I think I wasted too much of time talking to you. Yeah, individual. Anyway, I'm just showing it to you what I have done. You can do it again. So now I have so many ones which is saying that the point is inside the circle and zeros points which are outside the circle. Now, I can find out how many ones are written. Then it will tell me the how many points are inside the circle. So, what I have done, I am just showing you. I went to this position and then sum. So, if I can do sum equal S-U-M, sum, open bracket. And then I will go over here and highlight everything. So, when I am highlighting, it is adding up all the ones. Zeros automatically. I will add up to 0. So it is adding up all the ones. Okay. And if I do enter, I'm going back to that position. If I do enter, automatically the number will get highlighted. So I did this and enter. So I've got 114 points are there. This is how you can find out how many points are there. Okay. Then I'm really sorry. I think I did. Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, please.
Actually, there is a command like a function which is called COUNTIF.
COUNTIF, yes.
Yeah. So, what you do is you just write in a cell COUNTIF. After that, you give the range.
Okay.
separated by a comma. After that, within the quotes, write say less than 90, because that is what was your idea of counting how many points are lying within the radius.
Okay.
So you will immediately get the total number of points which are within the quarter circle.
Okay, that means it will keep counting after 1, 2, 3, 4, like that.
Whenever you update the random number, that count will also change because your numbers are changing.
Fantastic. Okay, I hope you have understood. What I did is I just got 1, 1 and added it later on. Sir is telling, yes, there is one count if. If I do count if it is there already, then it will count. This one is 1, this will be 2, this will be 3, this will be 4. And the final number will come at the end, which will tell me 114.
It will give you in one cell only the final answer. You don't need to. You have to just give specify the range.
Huh.
And just in that count if function, if you write the range, say the comma, and the criteria. Criteria is within the brackets, say less than 90 in this particular case.
Okay.
You will get immediately the number.
Okay. So, this is other ways. I mean, there are umpteen number of ways. It is not just the only way. Okay. So, please be aware. If you are smart, okay, I am not that smart, so I have not been able to do it. But if you are smart, you will be able to do. There are very many ways. Yeah.
I just want to add one thing.
Yes, sir.
Actually, as you have been telling, that we should actually start practicing. We have been telling them also this.
Yes.
So, when we start doing problems, actually, what happens is, we keep on coming across these difficulties.
Hmm.
And then we keep on searching for the answers also.
Okay.
And today, so much help is available on the internet itself that you immediately find out, oh, this is the way it can be done. So, the participants who are sitting here should not really worry unnecessarily that, oh, this is very difficult. No, it is not difficult. You should have a right question in your head. For example, can I count the number of things written in a cell in Excel, and you will find Google will take you to 100 places to do all those things. So these children should actually, and they are very good actually, they are very smart.
They
are much smarter than us actually. They will be able to search for all these things.
Yeah,
but
definitely.
I must say that you did wonderful, you know, exercise, such elaborately, experiment also you did, and then you did such a beautiful exercise. I must admire you. It was just great. I enjoyed it.
I want to finish it in another 10 minutes. I want to show you all the other possibilities. Mm-hmm. I know it is late, but please excuse me, sir. Okay, sir.
Yes. Please carry on. I'm really interested to see the next two columns.
Yeah, I want to show the money completely so that
yes.
They can go ahead. Okay. Now, I wanted to find out the pi value. So, I went to one cell and wrote the formula 4 times number of points in the circle divided by number of points in the square. Now, I have both of them. So, if I found out the ratio, it got me the value pi. Pi is equivalent to 3.04 now with this random. If I want to change the random number, just with one click, I'm changing and I have 3.183. I asked 20 children to do it separately and they gave me different answers. Now, I don't have to do it with 20 children. My computer itself, every time I click, it is giving me a different value of pi. So, the pi value can range from whatever small value to higher value. How will I know? I have just written those values down. Just 10 values I have written down. I can keep on clicking and getting infinite number of pi's. I don't have to wait for anything. Just by one click, the random numbers are changing and the pi value is changing. Each time I find out the value of pi, I am getting an error. Therefore, I am calculating the error. And that error is delta pi. How I will find the error? Here, the random number is either inside the circle or not inside the circle. Therefore, I say it is a binary distribution. For binary distribution, now these things you have to search for it and find out. I also did not know. I struggled hard to find out where it is, how can I find out the uncertainty. And I realized, yes, whenever it is a binary distribution, then it is the value into that, if it is inside the circle or not inside the circle. Therefore, it is pi by 4, 1 minus pi by 4, whole divided by the total number of points in the total number of points, square root of that will give me delta pi by 4. If I multiply this quantity on the right hand side with 4, I will get delta pi. That formula I have used, and I found out for every time I'm finding out pi, I'm calculating the error in the pi, and the error in the pi is always 0.1413, 1413 in this situation when I have whatever 142 points, etc. If this error is now confirmed that yes, it is 0.14, and I have so many pi's, please listen to this carefully. I have so many different pi's. I am finding out trial 1, trial 2, trial 3, so many times value of the same pi. Therefore, I can find out what is my error by statistical analysis. And therefore, I can calculate what is standard deviation. So hence, I have just written down a few values of pi. So these values of pi, each of them have an error equivalent to 0.02. The deviation from the average, I have found out the average of that value, 3.1598. And here I'm finding out what is the deviation from the average of each of these values, square of that. Ma'am yesterday showed us that if I simply find out the deviation, it can be positive or negative. And the sum of all the positive negative errors is always equivalent to zero. Therefore, it is meaningless to find out the deviation alone, which will give me the positive value or negative value, because the sum will be always zero. Therefore, if you take the square of that, it will always be a positive value, and hence you can calculate what it is known as the variance by summing up. So if I find out lambda average minus lambda I, which is this value, that means 3.1598 minus 3.014, square that, I will get a value 0.02. Like that, I have calculated for all these values, square, added it up, sum. This sum is known as the variance. Then from the variance, you can find out the standard deviation. Since I have squared it, I can't take any number and square it and say this is the deviation. It is deviation square. And therefore, for finding out the standard deviation, the formula is square root of the variance divided by n, the total number of terms, minus 1, square root. So that I have done. I have not written the formula over here. But if I take you over here, you will see square root of this number divided by n minus 1. I have 10 numbers over here. 10 minus 1 is 9. Square root of that will give me the standard deviation, which I have got it as 0.12. Therefore, I have said that my standard deviation is 0.12, but my error in each of these pi's is close to 0.14. Hence, I should write pi. If I have calculated many number of times, I should write the value of pi. I wanted you to tell me, but unfortunately, there's not much time. So I should write over here 3.099 plus or minus. Okay, I'm not writing plus or minus. I have to go to insert value and take the plus or minus sign from there, which I have written over here, let us say. So I will do insert and close, and then I should write 0.1. I want to also tell you this. Since my error is having two significant figures, I should write my value over here accordingly. So I can't write 0.099. I should write over here 0.01. Two digits over here, two digits over here. This is how your values should be reported with the corresponding uncertainties. If you have repeated the value many number of times, then calculate the standard deviation and write the standard deviation as the uncertainty for the corresponding value, which is the average value. So I should write this value actually, 3.159. I should not write 0.1. I should write it as 1.6. So 3.16 plus or minus 0.14. My average value and the corresponding standard deviation is the way how I should report my value. Okay, so I hope I have made it clear. Now, again, I'm trying to tell that this error is 0.12 when I have taken it as 142 points. I have taken 142 points. If you take it many more points, instead of 142, if you take it, let us say 1042, then this error will decrease tremendously. It will become probably 0.02. Therefore, it is always best to take large number of points whenever you are doing your reading, so that your error will become minimum, as small as possible. All right. I'm not going to the PPT. There's plenty more other things written over there. But I think this much is good enough for you. And I want you to please practice it and come tomorrow so that you feel confident. Yes, you have understood how to do a thing, particular thing, activity in your spreadsheet. And then you can learn more and more. So thank you very much. And I'm really sorry for taking so much time. Please pardon me. Yes, I will. Yeah, I will. I will. All right. Yeah, I will do it. Here I have written standard deviation formula, square root of pi average minus pi I whole squared, whole divided by n minus 1. And this whole thing has to be square root. So if you look at those formulas, you will realize, I'm sure you would have done it in your classroom. You can use your knowledge. And then if you do not know anything, go to help. Okay, I will put it up.
I only want to say to the dear participants, particularly my students, that actually, you know, when you start doing things, then you start learning. The only way to learn is do. And that is what I have been trying to stress right from the very beginning. You will have to make a habit. In fact, when I was listening to ma'am, when she was doing the experiment, I started doing things on the spreadsheet itself. Because I found, why not write down X and Y values there only? Why to write down on a paper? Right? So that was my way of, you know, immediately going to something which I know and start appreciating and applying it. And there were many things, you know, which came on the way which we tried to learn, many commands we learned, and this is how actually it happens. And you can see the stamina of them also, that she spoke non-stop for 2 hours. Then we must have a good cup of tea after this.
So thank you, Pesh, for listening patiently. I'm really sorry for taking more time, and that is because you are not in a classroom. I'm not able to see you, whether you are progressing or not. And I'm keen that you will also progress along with me. So please pardon me. Tomorrow, I think I will do whatever I want to do and leave it as a home task for you to do it at home. Okay, I will upload all the required documents.
There is one thing more which I want to tell the students. Today, yes, I think at this time, there are about 31 participants. There was one, you know, in the WhatsApp group, there was a question regarding series. So I have already posted a spreadsheet on the classroom, giving you an example of summing first n natural numbers, squares of the natural numbers, cube of the natural number, and you can extend it. Plus, another additional thing, finding the factorial using the recursive procedure. You can find factorial by a function also in the Excel itself. But I said, no, let us expose ourselves to the what is happening at the back of that function itself. So I have given it there. I will request Ma'am Sapna also, you know, to post those experiments in the classroom. Okay. Sapna, your mic is not working. Please switch it on.
I'll do it, sir.
So that they come to know some experiments which are already, you know, listed by University Grants Commission. Students can do for doing a course on computational physics via Excel. I think it has been a great day, great service. I hope Kulvinder ji must be feeling very happy with the success story of this program. And tomorrow, I think we are going to have another wonderful session with ma'am. Great. There was one point also which ma'am mentioned within the lecture that was regarding random numbers. I will just mention very briefly in 2 or 3 sentences that the random numbers which we use in the computer are pseudo-random numbers. But the ma'am was generating random numbers which were 2 random numbers. So we must really understand and appreciate the difference between that. That she was producing in from the bag true random numbers. Why I am calling that these are pseudo random numbers? Because at the back, there is some algorithm which is working to generate these numbers. And there are very many algorithms by which you can produce these random numbers. And there is a whole class of, you know, programs by which you can test these random numbers also. So testing of random numbers is one of the most essential things which you must do in the beginning. And because ma'am has already told you, actually you should try to test by a very simple method of plotting these points within a square. Generate points between 0 and 1, plot 1000 points. If you find that these numbers are distributed uniformly, then you should feel happy. But if they are clustering somewhere, then you should start worrying about it. So these are very few remarks which I wanted to make. One more remark was, ma'am actually mentioned about that our quarter circle was not looking at arc, was not looking at a quarter arc of a circle. So she tried to, you know, make the x and y equal. Technically, this is called aspect ratio. That in the computer, the number of pixels along x direction and y direction are actually different. That is why that happens. If you actually make the cell size of the sheet such that it is not rectangular, but it is a square, then you will find that when your circle will come, automatically aspect ratio will be okay. So that is another way, another trick to do that aspect ratio business. So I think these were my small comments.
So hopefully very useful. Thank you very much.
This will help. And good luck, boys and girls. You are there for all the time. Wonderful. Wish you all the best. Please keep on exploring. That is how one should do. And एक ना संस्कृत में कहावत है, संस्कृत का एक वाक्य है जो मैं आपको बोल के बताना चाहता हूँ, वो है अभ्यासेति आनंदेति. इफ यू विल प्रैक्टिस यू विल एंजॉय, इफ यू विल नॉट प्रैक्टिस यू विल नॉट एंजॉय. सो प्लीज
अभ्यासेति
आनंदेति.
यस, सो वी हैड अ wonderful session, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you very much for your cooperation and patience. Thank you so much.
But it was so interesting, actually. I didn't realize that it's already 7:15. I didn't realize that, actually. So I was too much
engrossed. Do it in the classroom. You take about 1 hour 45 minutes if the children are doing. But it was a little difficult for me to communicate and get
the answers. Yes. But anyway, thank it was very much. Nice. Very thank good. You. Very good.
Thank you very much. So thank you very, very much, Dr. Mann, for giving this opportunity and listening. The children were also there. A good number, 31 is a good number, I would say. All of them were there. So thanks a lot. Okay, sure. So tomorrow's session will be also a little long because I want to do two things. First, I want to do something basic and then a little more complicated thing. Hopefully, I will try to do, I won't ask children to do it with me, because it will take a long time, but I will show the entire process so that they can do it at home. Okay, sir? Thank you. Yeah.
So thank you very much. Thank you, dear students. You were there all the time. Great. And I loved the session. Thank you very much. And I'm signing off now.
Thank you. Sir. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Good night.
Sure, sir. Sure.
Okay.